huge ton of plastic waste enters into the ocean. It would be hard for us as individuals alone to take certain actions that would make great changes. The ones who can control this issue are the manufacturers themselves. Let us take some of the examples on how certain company product packaging ideas can actually save the world.
We have Baker's Edible Cutlery. They are aimed at reducing plastic waste. They are made from millets, rice and wheat. They come in different flavors and can be used for 3 years. They can be consumed after use or can be thrown out. Saltwater Brewery has produced 6-pack drinks for their product, which is being made out of barley with wheat. This dissolves in less than 2 hours. This can also reduce danger of animals being choked on plastics. Edible water capsules are made out of thin seaweed coating. These capsules itself are edible and reduces the production of water bottles. Shampoo pots are also helpful in reduction of solid waste. The plastic covering the product are non-toxic and dissolves in water. Toothpaste tablets are chewable tablets, and this ensures that no products are being wasted.
Environment and the need for protecting it. Environment plays an important role in healthy living and existence of life on planet Earth. Earth is a home for different living species, and we all are dependent on the environment for food, air, water, and other needs. Therefore, it is important for every individual to save and protect our environment. Environmental protection is one of the basic prerequisites for the overall development of any country in the world. If economic growth and development are to be established, there is no country in the world that does not want to do so. Biodiversity must be contributed. 5 initiatives have been initiated by the Modi government as a step towards a green India. From the Namami Gange program to arrest pollution and revive River Ganga to Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, the National Cleanliness Drive, Prime Minister Narendra Modi is ensuring that growth and environment go hand in hand. According to State of India's Environment SOE report, India's position of Global Environment Performance Index fell from 141 in 2016 to 177 in 2018. Every citizen should be responsible for safeguarding our environment. Government initiatives have played a huge role in helping find solutions to the problem. From building toilets to ramping up cleanliness through the Swachh Bharat mission, the Modi government has time and again garnered people's attention and support for the right cause. Namami Gange program. The Namami Gange program was initiated by Narendra Modi when he took power as Prime Minister of India in 2014. This program was taking place in June that year. Recognizing the cultural and environmental importance of the River Ganga, the Namami Gange program was approved by the Union Government. The center allocated a total of ₹20,000 crore to conserve and rejuvenate the river. While there had been a number of other programs to improve the state of River Ganga, the Modi-led government stated that it was approaching the problem differently. It involved the people living on the banks of the river and helped them attain sustainable livelihoods and feel the impact firsthand. It also roped in grassroots level institutions, including urban local bodies and panchayat raj institutions, to work for the same. Key achievements include creating sewage treatment capacity, riverfront development, and surface cleaning. The program is being implemented by the National Mission for Clean Ganga at national level and State Program Management Group at state level. Moreover, 63 sewage management projects are implemented in Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand, and West Bengal. Next, we have Green Skill Development Program. The Green Skill Development Program was launched in June 2017 by the Ministry of Environment, Forest, and Climate Change. Green skill refers to those that contribute to preserve and restore environment and create a sustainable future. Hence, the program focuses on developing skills among the youth in the environment and forest sector. During the pilot phase, the ministry introduced courses for biodiversity conservationists and parataxonomists for 3 months at 10 different locations. It's a successful project, as 94 trainees successfully completed the basic course qualifying as skilled biodiversity conservationist and 152 trainees completed the advanced course qualifying as skilled parataxonomists. Next, we have Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. The National Cleanliness Drive Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is perhaps the most popular campaign relating to environment that the Modi government pulled off. launched on Mahatma Gandhi's birth anniversary on October 2, 2014. The movement had people coming out to clean the roads across India. Photographs of Modi sweeping the streets became quite a sensation for some time as he kick-started the first cleanliness drive. Over the years, different versions of the campaign were started. This includes Gramin Swachh Bharat Mission and Bal Swachhta Abhiyan. These look at implementing the same effort in rural India and instilling the same values among children, respectively. It is a successful mission as 500 million people have stopped defecating in this open since the SDM began. Down from 550 million at the beginning of the program to less than 50 million today, over 9 crore toilets have been built across rural India under the mission. Finally, we have Compensatory Afforestation Fund Act, CAMPA. The Modi-led government introduced Compensatory Afforestation Fund Act in 2016. It also established the National Compensatory Afforestation Fund and State Compensatory Afforestation Fund the same year. Under this act, any individual or organization intending to use forest lands for non-forest purposes will be charged. According to provisions in the Act, payments include present net value of the forest, compensatory afforestation and other specific projects relating to environment. Of this, national and state funds will receive 10% and 90% respectively. Funds generated are then used on reviving the forest ecosystem and protecting wildlife. Notably, the India State of Forest report stated that India saw 1% increase in its overall forest cover between 2015 and 2017 by adding 6.778 square kilometers of forest cover. So, government is doing their best to protect the environment by putting forward various expensive programs, as I have mentioned some of them earlier. So, as citizens, we ought to take necessary steps in protecting our environment. As we say, small steps can create big changes. So let's start it from our home. Thank you. Trainees completed the advanced course qualifying as skilled para taxonomists. Next, we have Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. The National Cleanliness Drive, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, is perhaps the most popular campaign relating to environment that the Modi government pulled off. Launched on Mahatma Gandhi's birth anniversary on October 2, 2014. The movement had people coming out to clean the roads across India. Photographs of Modi sweeping the streets became quite a sensation for some time as he kick-started the first cleanliness drive. Over the years, different versions of the campaign were started. This includes Gramin Swachh Bharat Mission and Bal Swachhta Abhiyan. These look at implementing the same effort in rural India and instilling the same values among children, respectively. It is a successful mission as 500 million people have stopped defecating in this open since the SPM began. Down from 550 million at the beginning of the program to less than 50 million today, over 9 crore toilets have been built across rural India under the mission. Finally, we have Compensatory Afforestation Fund Act, CAMPA. The Modi-led government introduced Compensatory Afforestation Fund Act in 2016. It also established the National Compensatory Afforestation Fund and State Compensatory Afforestation Fund the same year. Under this act, any individual or organization intending to use forest lands for non-forest purposes will be charged. According to provisions in the act, payments include present net value of the forest, compensatory afforestation and other specific projects relating to environment. Of this, national and state funds will receive 10% and 90% respectively. Funds generated are then used on reviving the forest ecosystem and protecting wildlife. Notably, the India State of Forest report stated that India saw 1% increase in its overall forest cover between 2015 and 2017 by adding 6.778 square kilometers of forest cover. So government is doing their best to protect the environment by putting forward various expensive programs, as I have mentioned some of them earlier. So as citizens, we ought to take necessary steps in protecting our environment. As we say, small steps can create big changes. So let's start it from our home. Thank you.